Hi, I'm Ben from thedawstudio.com, and today we're talking about frequency and amplitude. So the first question is, what is sound? Sound waves are pressure changes of air molecules compressing together and expanding back out. They scatter in the air in all directions. If we could see them, they would look kind of like expanding bubbles. Another example to try and help you visualize sound waves is if you drop a rock into a pool of water. The important thing to realize is that the air and water are not traveling. The energy is traveling through the air and water. We like to draw and visualize this as a two-dimensional wave, like a simple sine wave. This graph has a y-axis and an x-axis, which correspond with the two main ways to define a sound wave. The x-axis represents frequency, or how many times a wave vibrates per second. These vibrations are defined as cycles starting with a resting point and compressing or moving up the wave, then rarefacting or moving down the wave, and then returning to the starting point. This is called one cycle because the wave has made one full revolution of a compression and rarefaction, returning to its starting point. If you swing the second half of the sine wave back, you see it as completing a circle, revolution, or cycle. A complete circle is 360 degrees. So if something is off by one half of a revolution, it's considered 180 degrees out of phase. The unit of measurement we use for frequency is hertz. For example, 100 hertz is vibrating, revolving, or cycling 100 times in 1 second. The human range of hearing is from 20 hertz or 20 cycles to 20,000 hertz or 20,000 cycles. Once we get into the thousands of hertz, our measurement can be shortened to kilohertz. So for example, 20,000 hertz is simply 20 kilohertz, and 5,000 hertz is 5 kilohertz. It's also common for audio engineers to simply say 20K or 5K. A common term that frequency relates to is pitch. A low frequency is a low pitch, and a high frequency is a high pitch. A440, which orchestras and bands often tune to, is the A pitch just above middle C, and is 440 hertz. So to sum up the x-axis, we have our technical term, frequency, our measurement, hertz, and our common term, pitch. The y-axis, or vertical axis, represents amplitude, or how much pressure the wave has, or how much the air is compressed. Amplitude is measured in decibels, which is written as dB with a capital B. The B is capitalized because it represents the creator's name, Alexander Graham Bell. After he invented the telephone, he pioneered many advancements in audio. The decibel is a very interesting measurement system. First, it's derived from a bell, which is a much larger measurement and is too big for common amplitudes. So we use the smaller decibel, or tenth of a bell. It's also weird in its pronunciation since we commonly slur it into decibel instead of decibel. So forgive me for using the common pronunciation. It can apply to multiple types of amplitude, including voltages in an analog system, dBV, as well as sound pressure level in acoustic energy, dBSPL. There are even more that we won't be going into in this video. Decibels are a linear representation of exponential information. Every 6 dB jump in sound pressure level is approximately equivalent to a doubling of the sound pressure. The actual scientific measurement of pressure is in pascals. For example, 0 dB, which is the threshold of hearing, is 20 micropascals. If we jump to 6 dB SPL, then it's roughly 40 micropascals. 12 dB SPL is roughly 80 micropascals. 18 dB SPL is roughly 159 micropascals, and so on. The issue is that if we use pascals, our numbers would have a crazy huge spread as we go from whisper volume, about 40 dB, 2000 micropascals, to loud concert volume, about 110 dB SPL, 6,324,555 micropascals, or 6.32 pascals. Something that gets really confusing is the difference between dB SPL and dBV. We've just been talking about dB SPL, which is the sound pressure level of acoustic energy in the air. Once the sound is captured by a microphone, the amplitude is transduced or converted to voltages, which are measured in dBV. The easy way to tell the difference is that dBSPL is usually from 0 up to 130 or so, where dBV is centered around 0, going up to about positive 18, and down to negative 60 or more. Everything within a DAW or mixer is dBV. Sound occurring in nature or an acoustic space is dBSPL. Sadly, many people just say dB and omit the SPL or V, which can get a little confusing sometimes. Now finally, the common term that relates to amplitude is volume. So to sum up the y-axis, we have our technical term, amplitude, our measurement, dB, and our common term, volume. If you enjoyed this video, please like below and subscribe to our channel where we'll be releasing more content like this. I'm Ben from thedawstudio.com, and we'll see you next time.